This video is brought to you by Squarespace. On this video, I'm gonna show you how we can cut to the beat. We are in the Final Cut Pro 10 interface, and the first thing that we obviously want to do is to bring our song into the timeline. I will drag the song and I will bring it into the timeline. I will right click in my mouse and click on lift from storyline. Now, the second way to do that is, let me delete this, by simply select your audio track and press Q in our keyboard. As you see again, we have the same result, our audio down and an empty gap above the audio. The first method to edit to the beat from the methods that we will showcase today is to work with markers. And what I'm gonna do right now is to select the audio clip. I will click here, and as you can see, by clicking these elements, I can adjust how large the audio scope is on the clip. We can turn that to the right a little bit so we can have a better idea where the beat drops. And having selected the audio clip, we press spacebar in our keyboard to start playing the track. And as we play the music where we want the cut to take place, we will press M in our keyboard. Let's go and see. Perfect. Now let's go and bring our clips. As you can see here, I have selected the start and end point. We can do that by pressing I in our keyboard for the start point and O in our keyboard for the end point. I'm gonna drag this with a left click. I'm gonna bring it into the gap and I will press replace from start. Now, with the left click, make sure that you have this option here selected to enable the magnetic cuts. I will drag with the left clip to the end and bring it to the marker. Now, let's bring the second clip. Again, we can select a portion with the I and O. Drag and bring it to the marker. And we will continue the same process to cover the gaps between our markers. And as you can see, we have finished with the first method to cut to the beat. Now let's go to the second method. I'm gonna delete all of this. Again, we go to the audio. We bring our audio here and lift from storyline or with a Q in our keyboard, as we said in the beginning. And now I'm gonna select the gap. And whenever I hear the beats that I want the cuts to take place, I'm gonna simply press Command and B in our keyboard. Let's go and see. And we have created the cuts here in our timeline. Now we go into the footages again, and we will drag the footage, we will bring it to the gap, and we will select replace from start. We will continue this process for all the clips that we want to insert. And let's see what we have so far. And that was the second method. Before methods 3 and 4, I want to talk about Squarespace. From websites and online stores to marketing tools and analytics, Squarespace is the all-in-one platform to build a beautiful online presence and run your business. If you are a YouTuber and you want to have a better SEO for your videos, or if you're a photographer, videographer, and you want an online presence, an online portfolio for your services, then Squarespace is the must-have service that I can recommend for you. You can choose between plenty of beautiful designer templates to start building your own website, and you don't need to have any knowledge in web design and web development to build your own website. So head over to squarespace.com/Emilio Free trial first and then 10% off when you're ready to buy using the coupon code Emilio. Now for the third method. Let's say that we have our clips and we want to bring all of our clips in the timeline, all the clips that we're gonna use. So we're selecting the first one, and by holding Shift in our keyboard, we're selecting all the other clips. And we're bringing all of them into the magnetic timeline. Now we will bring also our song, and we will hear the beat. And let's say here we want to create a cut. We will press in our keyboards the Alt or Option key and the right edge. And as you can see with the right edge, we have already created the cut to the right. We continue with the same process. Let's hear the song. And here we want the other cut take place. Again, we press Option and right edge in our keyboard. And let's say that here we want the other cut take place. Again, Option, right edge. Now, if we want the next clip to start, let's say from here, we will go, we will select the clip and press Option and left edge, and it will bring us the clip into the left. Now we can continue with the same process, and we will leave the song to play as we're pressing Option and the right edge to create the cuts. Perfect, and let's play to see. Third method is done. And now let's do the fourth method, the final method. We're deleting everything again. The fourth method is one of my favorite methods, and it's the completely manual cut to the beat. We're bringing our first clip. We will bring our song too. We can zoom in so we can see the beats a little bit better in our visuals. We press play. And let's say here we want to create a cut. We will bring it with a left click, or we will simply press B in our keyboard, cut this portion of the clip, press A in our keyboard, select the other portion and delete it. And we will continue the rest of the clips like that. Here we want the other one. And you got the idea of the fourth method. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and if you did, don't forget to hit the thumbs up, subscribe to my channel for more content like this one, and ring the bell to receive notifications every time I post a new video. Also, the very first episode of my podcast is live. You can listen through the link in the description down below. And if you want a one-on-one training in Final Cut Pro 10, you can click in the link in the description of this video to book a training session with me. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.